Hi guys, in this video I'm gonna show you how you can upload a CSV file into your Postgres database. Let's go right into it. It's open up already, so I'm gonna click on it. So right now I'm coming over to where the database are. So now you can either choose to create a database. I have already showed how to do that in my previous video. Check in the description for the link for that. So right now I'm just gonna use this database Postgres. I'm gonna click on it, then come all the way down to schema, then come all the way straight to table. When I get to table, I'm going to right click on it, then come over to create, then click on table. So I'm going to put in the name of the table, which is going to be a mock. Let's give it mock 2, then come over here to create the colon of the CSV file we want to upload to Postgres. Okay, here we are. So click the mock file.
Okay, now we wait for it to open up. Okay, now that it's open up, what I need from this file is the colon name of each colon. Now this file has 1000 rows, so what I'm gonna do now is I need to copy each of the colon names into the table I'm creating in the database.
So right here I have ID, then I have first underscore name, then last underscore name. So I'm gonna copy this from here. I'm gonna copy this and come over here to my Postgres, click on a colon, come here to the plus, click on the plus, then paste that in. After pasting the name ID in, the data type, depending what you want the data type to be, you can choose anyone you want from here. But I'm gonna go with character varying this. Just wanna show you. Then we have not null. Then we have the primary key right here. You can choose to on it so I can put a primary key on this role of the colon called ID. But I'm just gonna off this for now.
I need to put the name of each of the colon into this table. So let's do a quick montage. Okay, I'm back from the montage, and now we have done putting in all our colon names into our table colons, and the data type we chose is character varying. We're not going to add any not null to it or make a primary key. We're just going to leave it like this. Then we're going to click on save. Yep, so let's do that now.
Save it. Then after saving it, we want to query the table we just created. We have public dot, then the name of the table we created, let's run this.
Okay, now we have queried our table and that's just displayed, but all is showing now is the colon name. We don't have any data in the table yet, so that's why it's appearing like this. So all those things we're seeing are the colon name. So let's copy our data into it.
So the next thing we're going to do, we are going to insert in the data, the CSV file. Just gonna type copy. public dot, so we're just going to copy this, copy, then paste, then we're going to type from, okay, then the name. So this time what we need is the location where the file is, so we're gonna come up here. Now there's something very important you need to take note of. You will not be able to upload the file, this CSV file, from the C drive. You either have to move it to a D drive or another drive that you have on your system, but not from the C drive. Let me show you why you won't be able to do that. So let's just copy the location where it is, copy, then go back, then paste it in, then the name of the file, which is mock, two, oops, the small letters, dot CSV. So now we have delimiter, quotation, then we have CSV, header, let me also make this capital letter. Okay. So now run it. So this is why you won't be able to upload the file from C drive. It's going to tell you permission denied. Then int, it says copy from instruct the Postgres server process to read a file. You may want to client side facility such as PSQL. So the best way place to put the file so they can upload it to your Postgres is D drive, which I've done already. So I will copy my D drive already. So right here, click my D drive, and this is it right here. So let's go back, then I'm just going to remove all this. Okay, so now let's upload. Okay, so this is why we're having this. It was because of I didn't put a quotation mark here. No, this sign here. So let's run it. And can I say see successful? So everything. So we have 1,000 copy. So now let's query the table. Come here, then run it. And boom, we have our table right here. and our CSV file has been uploaded into our table so that we can do that. Now there's a second way, much easier and faster. So after you have done naming the table, that is okay, so let's come here. So after you give the table the name and you copied the colon names of the table of the CSV file you want to copy, after you have done that, yes, you can now come back here, right click and come over to import. Once you click on import, you put the name of the file, or right here, you come up here first and click on import, because you are importing. Then you can put the name of the file, or you could just come and click here. It's much better you just click there. Then let's look for the file. Yeah, so this is it, the CSV file. Just click on it, then select, click on select, then click on OK, and you can see it successfully completed. So those are two ways you can import CSV file into your Postgres database. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe. Bye.